All right, so good afternoon everyone. Class number one, week number?
Number seven.
So, in this class today, we will touch another important application of diodes. What is really the major thing that's make this diode specific? What do we know? Something that makes this diode specific. We studied last time, what application? Rectifiers, yes or no?
Yeah.
Very good. Now, what makes a rectifier a rectifier? What's that? Current direction? Who said that? Yeah, go ahead. Only. But the other direction is not. So that what makes a rectifier a rectifier. That's a property that we use in the diodes to make rectifiers. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Very good. Excellent. So the same property will be used also in this application. And this application basically talks about how to fix the voltage at the output, okay? Limit it, meaning to not allow that voltage to go beyond that. And not only that, but we will use also the property of that the forward bias voltage of the diode is also fixed, yes or no, and how much is that? Roughly 0.7, of course, based on the CVD model, which is the very close model to the real one. I forgot my pointers, so today I will use my hands mostly. So, in the circuit limiters, which is one of the most important applications for the diode, basically, the transfer characteristic, what do we mean by transfer characteristic?
Input-output.
Exactly, the input-output characteristic. It means how to know the output if we know the input. So in the transfer characteristic or input-output characteristic, basically, if the input is below a certain value or above a certain value, the output will be set constant, okay? But in between these two values, the output follows the input with a certain function, with a certain profile. We'll talk about that little by little, okay? So the most popular and the one that is widely used and we use most of the time is basically the linear one. The linear one, that means in the region between these two boundaries, the output is linearly related with the input. It means there's a line between them. There's a slope. Very good. And if you want to define it, you know, globally here, the output here means the output is equal to a certain constant K times the input voltage. Okay? Well, over the linear range, what is the linear range? It's between these two boundaries. Okay? Outside that linear range, means below this value and above this value, the output is constant. That's it. This is the simplistic way of describing it. We can make it even more detailed because this is not detailed. I mean, here we are talking outside, inside, blah, 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 blah. But math, we don't like that. We want to put it in a nice equation, means the output is equal to a certain negative value, L minus. When the input is below that lower limiting threshold, which is this one, okay? And it is equal to a positive value, L plus. When the input is above this upper limiting threshold, which is this one, L plus that one. And in between them, in this between this boundary and this boundary, okay, then the output is equal to KV1. So, very good. So this is a simplistic limiter circuit transfer characteristic, okay? We'll increase the complexity and the properties of this limiter circuit. Let's see where we go next. All right, good. All right, now we'll talk about the different flavors, different varieties of the circuit limiters. So, because we're talking about limiters, first thing we have to check is the linear range between the boundaries. We have basically, in that sense, we have two types. We have the passive one and the active one. The passive one, basically, it takes the input multiplied by a certain constant. So it's really linear, okay? So it's that way, we call it passive. It does not do non-linear function for the input to get the output, okay? So that's what we call the passive limiters, okay? Talking about this K less than one or below or above one, K needs to be constant and that's it, okay? All right, In contrast to the passive, we have what we call the active. The active basically limiter, the active limiter takes the input and make it, you know, exponentially or quadratic. The output in the linear range would be equal to the input square or square, something that is non-linear basically, okay? So that's active, why? Because it's not linear. It's not like here and multiply that you have. Very simple. That in the active basically make it more non-linear fashion. Okay? Now, in terms of the limits, we have also two types. We have a single limiter and we have a double limiter. Single limiter means it has only one limit. So the output is limited only on one threshold. There's no two thresholds. So there's only one linear region and one limited region, okay? And the double limiter, we'll see these examples. Don't worry. I'm telling you now, but we'll see the examples. And the double limiter is basically the same like we have before. So basically the limiter has both the positive limit and the negative limit. And the linear region, of course. Okay? Good? Yes, sir.
Sir, so K should be constant, but it shouldn't exceed 1, so the output must equal...
For what? To be what? To be linear?
Yeah, I'm talking about the passive.
K, yes, okay.
So the
maximum... Really, I have... That's basically, it's not really that important. There's no... For linear, there's no requirement on K, really.
Oh, okay.
I have to take... This is a typo. I have to take it down.
So
okay?
It can be more...
K can be anything. Can be +1, -1, whatever value. The only thing we require to have a line there, that K is constant, period. We have slope. That's all what we really care about, okay? So I have to take this down. I will update the slides, okay? So K needs to be only constant. All right. So this we just explained. And the last, not the least, we have also another category I have to apply here. We'll talk about it next. Is that whether it's a soft limiter or a hard limiter? I think it's the next slide. Let's see. All right. Oh, it's in the next slide. Here. What you see in red is what we call hard limiter. What you see in blue is soft limiter. What's the difference between the two? Both of them, they have linear region here. But here, in the limiting region here, the hard limiter is basically constant. But the soft limiter, there is a slope here or here. It can be both, it can be one of them. So here, the limiter here is soft limiter here in the blue one. So the blue limiter, the limiter that has the blue transfer characteristic, has what we call a soft limiting property. Okay? So again, we have three definitions. We have the passive active, means linear, nonlinear region. We have the single limiter, double limiter, and we have the soft and hard limiter. Okay? So these three things, they describe, okay, the type of the circuit limiter that we try to implement or design. Okay? Any question? Clear? Good. All right. Before we move forward, where we need the limiter circuit? It's a good question. So the limiter circuit, the purpose of the limiter circuit is basically it limits the input. It doesn't allow the input to be beyond a certain value. We need the input to be within a certain range. Sometimes we multiply the input by a certain constant, and that's okay. That's K. Sometimes we let the input come in and go out in the, within that boundaries, within that limits. So basically that's the idea. But we don't want the input to be beyond above a certain value or below a certain value. And when we need that, we need it in basically as an input stage, as an input circuit for another circuit. So for example, an amplifier does not allow the input to be above certain value or below certain value. Why? Because it will not work properly. So the circuit limiter will tell, okay, I can do that for you. Okay? I will limit the input, so basically we take anything in the input, and we'll provide the output of that circuit, the value within certain those ranges, will not be above or below certain value, okay? Right? So mostly you find them in as an input to amplifiers. Why? Typically to avoid breakdown. We'll talk about this when we touch the amplifiers, okay? Okay. Because the amplifiers, they are also made of transistors, and we don't want those transistors, their diodes, to be in the breakdown. We want them to be in the on or off, that's it, not in the breakdown. We don't want that, okay? All right, that's just basically to say the application of the circuit emitters. All right, here comes the fun, okay? I'm sorry, I forgot my pointer, or my laser pointer, but I will try to use my mouse here to describe the thing. So the first circuits, there are A and B, basically, are, they are the first examples, the most simple basic examples of the circuit limiter. So in A, for example, you have a resistor, and in series with a diode, and the output, we are taking it where? Across the diode. This looks like what? Can somebody tell me about this? We have seen this before. No, CVD is the model for the CVD is the model for the diode. We're not talking about the model. I'm talking about application. Rectifier. It allows the current goes one way, not the other way. That's okay. But if we don't have an AC, rectifier works in AC. Yes or no? But if we have a DC. If the input, you see the input is on the left, yes or no? Yeah. In your left, my right is your left. So, if the input is DC, yeah. So this circuit looks like what? With what? Very good, very good, very good. That's a voltage regulator, yes or no? Because in this case, if the diode is on, the voltage across that diode gets constant, yes or no? Because the diode in the forward looks like what?
A battery.
A battery, that's it. So, and in the regulator, of course, you revise that, for sure. In the regulator, the voltage across the diode will be constant. Yes or no? You see? So, a rectifier looks very close to, very similar to a voltage regulator. The only difference is that the input in the rectifier is AC, yes or no, changes plus or minus. But in the voltage regulator, the voltage is basically constant, yes or no? It doesn't change direction, plus or minus, yes or no? And provides you at the output, basically, something that is constant. Why? Because the diode has constant voltage in the forward, yes or no? See, same circuit, but two different applications. Shows you how you really engineers must be really intelligent. And you need to do that if you want to continue this career. Oh, good. So now let's talk about it. So when the diode in circuit A will conduct?
When the S is more than.
We are talking now of the condition on the input. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So for DC. We are not talking about any AC here.
So
the input, what's the condition on the input to have the diode on?
When
raise your hand. No, raise your hand, please. Yes, then? When what? The input voltage is equal to 0.7. What about the above or below? If it's above 0.7, is it conducting or not? No, maybe or not. You have to be sure. Will conduct. So the diode will be only on one condition, that the input voltage is above 0.7. Yes or no? If the voltage above of the input is above 0.7, it will conduct. And in that case, the voltage across the diode will be equal to what? Is it equal to? Raise your hand. Yes? So. And so the output will be equal to what? From the circuit. So what is the circuit? So the output will be equal to? Yes, continue. Give me one answer. It's very invisible there. See, when the diode is on, it would be like what? Replaced by, what's the model? The output voltage is equal to what? 0.7, there's no magic about that, yeah? There's no magic about that. The output voltage would be VD, that's it, 0.7. Better, huh? Is there a magic about that? Ah, very good. So now let's go back. So if the input is below 0.7, if the input voltage is below 0.7, the diode is what?
Open circuit.
So is there any current?
No.
See, it's open circuit, so there's no current. So that means the voltage there, the voltage of the input voltage, will be equal to?
Output
voltage. Yes or no? So let's write that down. Let's do that. So V output is equal to V input if V input is less than V. Yes or no? Am I right or no?
Yeah.
Now, oh wait. Ready? Are you cool? If V input below VD, V output is equal to V input. Is that right or no?
Right.
Yes, that's right. Because there's no current. Yes or no? I scared you, huh? You know. So now, basically, this is like a line, yes or no?
Yeah.
So if I have delta here, I have delta here, that means delta V out over delta V in, which is basically the slope of the transfer characteristic, yes or no? So it's equal to 1, yes or no? That's what we have in this line, yes or no? On A, so if you look at the blue line, so it's 1, yes or no, up to 0.7, yes or no?
Yeah.
Very good. So when V input is above 0.7, the output is equal to?
0.7.
And that's why we have the next segment, V out is equal to constant, yes or no? There and here. That's why laser pointer is good. This segment, okay? Good? Very good. Now, what do you call this limiter? Wait, just a second. To call a limiter, we have to get all the three properties. We have to check this, and give it a name. Like, for example, if I tell you what's your full name, you start. First name, and some countries like this country, for example, then dad's name, and then the granddad's name. Yes or no? And maybe Qabila also. Why not? Same thing for limiter. When I tell you what's the limiter, din, and that's it. Go ahead. Yes.
Linear.
What's that? There's no linear. We didn't call linear. What do we call?
Passive.
A passive.
Single
limiter. Passive, single, mazal. Limiter, we leave it at the end. Passive, single, and? Hard limiter. Thank you very much. Excellent. Why hard? Can you explain?
Because the limit is
the output when it's limited is boom, constant. It does not change with the input. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
It's 0.7 and that's it. No matter what, how input is increased. See, excellent. Mm-hmm. That's the answer. So single, passive. You can start with whatever you want because we don't know who's the dad, who's the granddad, yeah? So you can start with whatever, huh? Let's say soft, single, passive limiter. That's okay. See? Oh, sorry. Hard. No. I'm so hard, single, passive limiter. See? Very good. Now the second example in B is the same as A, but what's the change? What did we change? Yes, go ahead. Add? Did we add anything?
No.
We just flipped the diode. That's it. We just flip. So what happens now? Basically, our analysis also will be flipped. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no? So now we can do the same analysis, but it's basically flipped. Yes or no? So the input in this case has to be below minus 0.7 to have a conduction. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no? Boom. And that's why, and in that case, the output will be limited as minus 0.7. Yes or no? Now, if the input is above minus 0.7, the diode is off. Yes or no? And in that case, back to that equation, V out is equal to V. Because there's no current, there's no drop of voltage across the resistor. Yes or no? There's no drop. That's why. If there was current, there would be voltage drop, and the output would be less than the input by that voltage drop. Okay? Clear? Any question? That's it. So it's very straight, again, the same nature, huh? So now we have a hard, single, passive limit. Very straight. See? Simple, huh? See, now, very clear situation. Now we make it a little bit spicy. Huh? How we do that? We add another diode for that circuit. We add another diode in the other direction. So we'll see things how they are. They change. Yes or no? Are you with me? Everybody with me? Yes or no? Good. I want you to be with me. If there's any question, please stop me. If you need to repeat, I will repeat. There's no problem. I'm here for you. Okay? Let's keep going. For this analysis, it's very simple. The engineers, they like to play games, and that's good. So let's think now only in the positive side. Yes or no? All right. If the input is positive, which of these diodes will be on and which one will be off? So D1, after certain blah blah threshold, will be on, but D2 will be always? Ah, very good. But before I continue here, look, we did something really, we did not mention something really, really important. And this you have to take note. Note in red. In the first circuit, when the diode is off, means below, when the input is below 0.7, yes or no? Really, in that case, the diode is reverse biased. But if we continue reverse bias, where we should go? In here, we did not assume breakdown, yes or no? Because if there was a breakdown, there would be current, yes or no? And in that case, the output and the input, they will not be equal, yes or no? Because there is a current through the resistor, and there must be a drop voltage, yes or no? But here we did not, and this is the important note. When we use the CVD model, CVD model applies only in which region? Forward. But for the CVD model, the reverse is basically off. There's no absolutely no breakdown for CVD model. Yes or no? Okay? There's no breakdown. It's just off, and that's it. Okay? This is the note that you should take. Huh? CVD model in the reverse assume no breakdown. Real diode, diode that is real, has a breakdown, yes or no? But if you use CVD model, that's it. Okay? CVD model only forward is battery, but reverse is just basically open circuit. Cool? Very good? All right. You can go at home as well and assume basically the breakdown and see what things will change in that graph, okay? Because we know the model in the breakdown. What's the model in the breakdown? Can you raise your hand and tell me? That's another question I like to ask. What is the model? Raise your hand, don't talk. I need to see people. No, raise your hand. What's the model of the diode in the breakdown? We model it like what? Raise your hand. Who knows? One. Who revised that? We did that. Yes or no? We have a model of diode and breakdown? Yes or no? Raise your hand. Who knows? One. Two. You don't know what's the three? Four. Okay, five, sorry. So five out of 2041. It's about eight, 1/8, yes or no? 1/8, 20%, right? Something like that. That's not good. You should revise. Yes. Yes, Zener diode is basically the diode in the breakdown. What's the model of Zener diode? In the breakdown, Zener diode is a regular diode. It's just the breakdown of Zener diode is small. That's all. It's like a riddle. So still the answer is not answered. The question is not answered. Who knows? What's the model of the diode in the breakdown? Yes, go ahead. No, that's application. Don't mix up. That's application. We are talking about model. When you talk about model, it means what do we replace the diode in the breakdown? Yes, go ahead.
Resistor and
the battery. The resistor and? Yes, very good. The resistor and the battery. 1/41. That's a very, very small. That shows that you are not revising. That's not good. I'm advising you, don't do that. So, just a quick refresh here. So basically, the diode in the, I will make it in red so that you don't forget. So basically, this is, if we are talking about the Zener, boom, 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 and this is zero. It's the same as real, there's nothing fancy about it, but if we are in breakdown, that's why we use Zener in that case. So basically here we have basically a battery, boom, boom, with a resistor in series, RZ, and that's it. So this is plus, this is minus. Okay, so this is VZ0, yes or no? And this is small RZ. Okay, that's how you replace it. And then once you replace it, then you do KVL to know the voltage and the output. Of course, you know how to do that. Okay, we'll talk about that in a second. Talk about it here. Okay, good. So far, so good. So back to our third example in here. What's the question? Is there any question here? Now here, okay, back to that example, the model, to make it just clear here. See, the cathode in the breakdown is actually bigger than the anode, because we are in breakdown. Very good. Happy with that. I know what you're talking about. You forgot that you are in breakdown. You are in the negative side. Yes or no? Got it? Because I can see from your face what's going on here. I'm not a teacher here for nothing. Okay, good. If you have any question, don't stop from asking. That's clear. I may make mistakes too. Okay? And you may tell me, maybe. All right, good. So that's fine. We can make mistakes. We should learn. That's all. So back to our business in here. Okay? See, I told you that the engineer is just a lazy person who doesn't want to repeat and make analysis complicated. Make just play games. So when the input voltage now is a positive, so this at some point will be on, yes or no? But this will be always off. We are assuming CVD model, huh? This will be always off, yes or no? Yeah. So that means we have that circuit, yes or no? A.
Yeah.
So that means I can take the characteristic there when the input is positive and copy it and paste it here. Yes or no? Got it? See how lazy we are? Copy paste. I see, computer age. See, so we took the positive side of the transfer characteristic of the circuit A, when the input is positive, we took it out, called cut, paste, boom, that's it. For the positive side, yes or no? Yeah, clear? The analysis is the same, I'm not going to repeat. Engineers, they don't like to repeat. Dun dun, and then we move, that's it, okay? Good enough? Any question? You are with me or still in the other world? With me, yeah? Okay, good. Now we play the other game. What if the input now is negative? So which diode is on and which one is off? Now they switch off, yes or no? So now this becomes off all the time, assuming no breakdown, of course. This one eventually will be conducting. So which circuit we are? We are in that circuit, yes or no? So now what I do as an engineer, I go there and take the half, the negative half when the input is, and cut it, and paste it. Voila, the game is over. See? Huh? Sweet, huh? That's the engineering, that's the engineering. It's not really something impossible. Even the kids, they can do that. Okay? So if you take it easy, it become easy. If you take it hard, it will be extremely hard. You understand? إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ إِيشْ بِالتَّعَلُّمْ وَالْحِلْمُ بِالتَّحَلُّمْ Yes or no? If you want to learn, you learn. If you want to you will also sleep. Yes or no? So that's the thing. You don't have to repeat yourself if you have something. But you have to know what you're doing. See? So we discussed first and foremost when the diode is on and when the diode is off. Huh? That's the best question. Very nice. Now, what's called this limiter? Who knows that? Ah, huh? The very long.
Passive.
Double.
Hardened.
Hardened. Thank you very much. Why? Passive. We know this slope is nothing. It's linear. Okay. And hard limiter. Boom boom. And what else we said? Double. Of course, you have limit here and limit here. That's the name. Why the name? Really? Why we need to name things? We name things because when we talk to each other. When I tell you the name of somebody, you automatically get a picture of that person in your brain, yes or no? I know that person by that name, yes or no? Because the name is associated in your brain with the picture of that person. The same thing here, okay? Here what we have, in our brains, now when we say the name of the limiter, I can imagine the transfer characteristic, yes or no? And little by little, I can build the circuit. I have a certain idea how to make it. Okay? That's that? That's how we We are really eager in engineering, especially in this class, to know the names of the circuits. So as soon as we hear the name, boom, we know what that looks like. Yes or no?
Very good.
Now back to these diagrams. We are actually in the third circuit. Okay. Again, we ask this first question is, when the diode is on and when the diode is off, yes or no? Can tell me when the diode here will be on? Raise your hand, try. This is a tricky, yes or no? Why it's tricky? Very good, because this is exactly that one. Hey, but the only thing we did, we just add a battery between the cathode of that diode and the ground. That's it. Very good. So, can somebody tell me when that diode will be on and when be off? Here the condition will be made on what? On the input voltage. That's the condition, yeah? And based on that, we know the output. So, can somebody try and answer the question when the diode will be on? I see basically there's a track here. There's like zzz, 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 and then zzz, zzz. And sometimes there is some noise here. And that's it. The rest are we need to wake up, huh? We need to try. Make mistakes, that's fine. I never blame anybody to make a mistake. Make a mistake. Not the end of the world. Yes, go ahead. We are talking now. Give me just answer. Boom. Try. So when this diode will be on? Huh? We are talking about the input, huh? What's the positive? Well, which one? Try. Go ahead. So this is positive.
Yeah.
So positive, how much positive? Yeah, the positive could be plus 1 volt, 10 volt, million volt. Positive, how much? How much? Okay, try. Keep trying. Most, yes, go ahead. Which one? The voltage? Which one? Is it the input voltage from here to here or this here?
In the diode.
So. But I need now, that one I don't know. What I have control is only on the input voltage, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm telling you.
But because we have the battery 5 volts, so 5 plus
0.7,
it will be only
5.7. Very, very. Of course, you looked out on the capacitor. I know that. You are smart. Okay, good. So here, basically, so for this is constant, yes or no? So what we need this to be on, we need the voltage here at least 0.7, yes or no? If it is above, it will be fine, 0.7, yes or no? Plus that at least voltage to make the current going on, yes or no? So the condition to have a current is that the input need to be above 5 plus 0.7, yes or no? Okay, let's write that down. So let's go there and back, okay? So in that case, okay, when the diode is conducting, so in that case, the output is equal to what? If the diode is on, then the output will be equal to?
5.7.
Very good. So, I will write V out is equal to 5.7 if the input is above 5 plus VD, that is 0.7. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
That's what it is. Yes or no? Now, what if the input is less than this value, 5.7. Sorry about that. We'll take that. Mm-hmm. Okay, 5.7. Yes or no? So if the input is less than this value, so the output will be what? So there will be no current here, yes or no?
Yeah.
And if there is no current, there is no current here as well, yes or no? That if there is no current, that means the voltage will be the same everywhere, yes or no?
Yeah.
So that means this will be equal to this. They share the same ground, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
So in that case, the out is equal to V.
That's it.
So I will write here, then I will come here. The out is equal to V. And the same story, also, delta V out over delta V input is going to be equal to, yes or no? Correct? So that's what it is.
So below 5.7, which is this threshold, we have a line here that relates the output to the input, yes or no? And above this limit, 5.7, the output will be always 5.7. Yes or no? Correct?
This is what mathematics tell us. Yes or no? We're not really...
Is it clear? Clear or no? It's not clear, can it? Go ahead. Again, we are not assuming breakdown. We are not taking breakdown. We are using just CVT model, which is battery when it is on and off when it is reversed. That's it. So CVT doesn't know about the breakdown at all. We're not counting the breakdown. Yes or no? Okay, cool. So all these limiters are not including or counting in or factoring in the breakdown mode or breakdown effect. Now, what do we call this? Yes, go ahead.
Passive, single.
Boom. That's it. Passive. There's a line here. Single, only one limit. And half, the limit is gone. That's it. Done. Is it hard?
No.
Piece of cake, yes or no? All right, any question? Good, excellent. All right, then we come to the spicy. What the spice is, when we now include the breakdown. We include the breakdown automatically when we use the zener. The zener is known for usage in breakdown. Yes, go ahead.
So if you have two diodes in series, but if you want to limit the circuit at voltage more than 0.5.
That's fine, that's okay. That's in this case, if you replace this one with the diode on the same direction, yes or no? So it will be this plus this. Yes or no? Of course. That's what it is. Because the voltage gets divided between them, yes or no? Cool. That's a good question. Nice? Now let's now talk about this one. Before we go talking about this one, let's talk about something else. Let's compare this to that circuit. So we said the only difference is the DC voltage in the cathode of that diode, yes or no? So this, look at the characteristic, how it changed. It's the same, yes or no? The only difference is that the limit now, instead of 0.7, it becomes 5.7, yes or no, because of this. And the same thing should be there, because here, it's 1-1, yes or no? If this increased, that one had to increase. So that's the difference between the two, yes or no? But the profile is the same. We are just shifting the limit, that's all. All right? The same thing if you replace now the battery, now if you reverse it. So now that shift will go down. Play this game at home. Okay, play this game at home. Now you need to do what? Play with these things and use KBL and your day will be full of fun. Okay? All right? Good, now we come to the final circuit. How we are doing now? We are doing well. Any questions so far? No question.
Yeah.
Well, yes?
We have two diodes and in opposite direction.
Okay. Say this in opposite direction.
Yeah.
Okay, let's think about it. Let's do that. Let's do that. Why not? Let's do that. Let's do what she suggests. So you are suggesting basically, you have basically like this. You have a resistor and you have something like this, yes or no? And another one like that, yes or no? And then there. And then we take the output from here to there, yes or no? This is V out and this is V in, yes or no? And this is R, the resistance, oops, that. And this is, let's say, V1, diode 1, diode 2, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
So, assuming, and no, there's no breakdown, of course, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
It's just a real diode, a diode with CVT model, basically there's no breakdown, but there's 4. Okay, is there any chance, when both diodes can conduct, okay, is it possible that these two diodes can go back simultaneously? Never. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Because if one is forward, the other one is reverse.
Yes.
And if we switch, we make the voltage negative, the same story. Yes or no? One diode will be on or the other one will be off. So there's no chance that the output, that there will be current. So it's always the current is zero, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no? In that case, the output is equal to what?
Mm-hmm.
So basically, if you want to draw the characteristic graph, that's it. One line, I will draw it in blue one. And that means the out. That's that equation, okay? Good enough? Don't stop from asking questions. And in fact, I want you to do that at home, play around. Okay? So is this a limiter at the end of the day?
No.
It's not limiter. It's not single, it's not double. So it's out of our business. Yes or no? It doesn't limit anything. There is no usage of this. Yes or no? Thank you for the question. Nice question. So it's not limited at all. Very good. Very good. Now, the same story, huh? The same story that she asked. But instead, we are going to count for the breakdown. And now things will become spicy. Yes or no? Because if we use Zener, that means we are telling ourselves that we are going to count for the breakdown. Yes or no?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. So, same analysis that we did it in here, we did it also in here, and everywhere actually. So we come here and we say, let's only look at when the input is positive. And we start to analyze, because there is a possibility that both they will conduct, yes or no? One of them, or both of them conduct at the same time, yes or no? One will be on, the other one will be on also, but in different region, yes or no? Possible, yes or no? Okay, let's look at the input when it is positive. When we will have a current in this branch, the output branch, this one. Because that's where our voltmeter is. That's our voltage measurement. Right. So in this case, you're saying?
It has to be more than D.
Than what?
Than D, then
D. Okay, so, and then, that's it?
So
the Zener the input has to be above Zener knee voltage, yeah. For which diode, this one or this one?
For the lower one.
Which
for
one?
For Z2.
For Z2, for the second. Because Z2 is?
Reverse.
Is in the reverse.
Yeah.
For Z2, that is in reverse in this case, for input voltage that is positive, for that one to conduct, it has to be in the breakdown. Oh, good. So the input has to be above that knee voltage of that. Is that the only condition?
And Z1 has to be above the normal V diode.
That is 0.7.
0.7.
So, very good. Thank you, Rim. So that means we will have a current here only and only if the voltage here, that is positive in this case, is above the knee plus 0.7. Got it? Clear? Yes or no? Let's now, in this case, do something really nice, systematic here. What is that? Let's draw table. Huh? This table is for the input. This is the input. Yes or no? And we say that the first limit is in the positive. Now we are in positive here in this side. Yes or no? Positive. This is negative. Yes or no? This is zero. Yes or no? All right, good. So Rin told us that really above this limit we will have both conducting. Let's see. And that limit is what? Is actually VZK of which diode? Of the diode number 2, yes or no? Plus 0.7, yes or no? So in that case, okay, in that case, we will have current in here, and the voltage here is equal to what?
0.7 plus
the knee voltage. Not the knee voltage, plus VZ in this case, because now if the input increase, also VZ will increase, yes or no? Very good. So in this category, in this side, so from here onward, so V output, so from here in this zone, okay, V out is equal to 0.7 plus VZ. VZ is what? It's basically the voltage across this one, yes or no? Because the breakdown voltage is not exactly constant. Remember? It's equal to what? VZ, if you remember, VZ is equal to VZ0 plus IZ, RZ, yes or no? Remember that? That's the model for the Zener diode in the breakdown, yes or no? Or is that strictly the breakdown model for any diode impact? Okay? Of course, revision. We cannot go back, huh? But we did it, yes or no? We said that the breakdown model for the diode is VZ0 plus RZ, IZ. Meaning that we are going to replace this by a battery plus a resistor. Yes or no? That's it. And the current there will have to pass by the battery, will not change the voltage, But if, when it passes by the resistor of this diode, it will increase the voltage across the whole diode. Yes or no? Because both of them, they are inside it. Yes or no? Clear? Things become spicy here. So now, if the current, if the voltage increases, the current across this will increase or not? The current will increase. Now, if the current increases, the voltage across this zener diode will also increase. And the output, which is equal to what? Which is equal to Vz plus 0.7. So Vz will increase in this case. So the output will also increase. Yes or no? Little bit. Why? Because Rz is small. Yes or no? So the output will increase by a little bit. Yes or no? Will increase a little bit when the input will increase. Yes or no? So it's not flat. Yes or no? So that's why we want Vz2 plus 0.7. Vz2 is not constant. It does depend on the input voltage by a little bit. And that little bit is what? Is the resistance Rz. Yes or no? Without Rz, the output will never change with the input voltage. Yes or no? Okay? Good? Clear? Very good. This is for this side. For the input, that is positive. Now, for the other side, what do they do? When the input is negative, now this voltage is both this voltage. So this becomes, at some point, forward. And this, in the breakdown, very good. We come back to that nice table here. We change the color here. So now, in that limit, is what? When the input voltage is negative, so it has to be above what? It has to be above this one forward, which is 0.7, plus the breakdown of this one. Yes or no? Of course, both of them in the negative. That's why we have here minus, yes or no? That plus that. The forward of this diode, 0.7, plus the breakdown of this one, the breakdown voltage of this one. Yes or no? Vz1. The same analysis that we did here will be applied here, but we have to switch now the breakdown, because the other diode will be breakdown, they switch from forward to breakdown. Yes or no? And the same story here. The voltage also will change with the input. Why? Because the input voltage, if it increases, the current will increase, and Vz across the breakdown diode will also increase because of the model of the breakdown voltage, of breakdown model of the diode. Okay? Okay? Clear? Very good? So here will not be flat anymore. It will change, and also here will change. What do you call this nice limiter? Resistance. President?
Passive.
Double. And soft. Very good. That's the one. That's the one. Very good.
What I want you to do at home is the following. Very easy. You need that to prepare for the class test. Go home, drink something. If you want to watch the video, watch the video to refresh, try to remember what we did today, and try to play around. What if one diode is opposite to that direction? What if we take the regular diode, CVD, regular diode? Regular diode is different from zener because the breakdown is so far that we can assume it is open circuit. Yes or no? That's why it's different. Okay, so play around with these things and see what kind of limiter you will have. Okay, the same analysis. See this table? So now we come back to that table. So this value in here will be minus 0.7 plus Vz, which one? This is the Vz what? The first one was Vz1, Vz2, sorry. So now Vz1, that's it. So when you go home and you play around, you change now these types of diodes, you put maybe DC voltage there and that, you will understand how to play with a limiter. And that's the whole point of this class, is to know how to play with these diodes, with this circuit, to do a limiter that is convenient for you. Okay? Is it difficult? Simple, yes or no?
So sir, we don't have any rule or whatsoever. We can put a normal diode with a zener diode with a
battery. Sure, there's no rule. Who said there's a rule? The only limiting thing here is to understand our models. What are the models for forward and breakdown? That's it. Did we put anything else? No. We were talking only about the models of the diode in the forward and the breakdown. That's all. Other than that, KVL in this case. Yes or no? KVL, KCL. Okay? All right? Is it clear? Very good. So, really, these circuits are really fun to play with. And they are really excellent applications of the diodes, okay? That really we can enjoy. And what else? That's it. So now it's up to our imagination. Okay. All right, so what's next? Next is second class. Will be after tomorrow. We'll talk about some nice application, some nice diodes, special diodes that we use in everyday life. One of the most famous one will be, not this one. Which one? What is the most famous diode that we use in every single day? Which one? Who knows? Yeah? No. LED, yes! The LEDs are the most famous diodes that we use them everyday life, okay? And the projector that is shooting your presentation is built out of millions of them, yes or no? Okay? Without LED, and that whenever you find the light source in an electronic device, there is 100% sure that's an LED. We'll talk about that. I will shoot also some nice video about that as well, okay? For you to see how these LEDs works, okay? All right? So the LEDs are the most, and you find them in cars, you name it, I mean in the panels, whenever there is a light source, there's an LED there, okay? That's the technology we are using nowadays. Any question? That's it? So see you next class, inshallah. Thank you.